What's up, my friends? Hello and welcome. Happy Tuesday. Who do we get first? Lady Iron was first, even though Coleman and Ursa said hello first. Wow. Coleman, how you doing? Good morning to you, and good morning, Ursa. And good morning, Lady Iron. Jersey says 10th. You're not 10th, Jersey. Can't wait to see what this game is about. So, have you not seen it before, Ursa? Koro, friends, how are you? A little sleepy? No, you're good. You're good. I had such a weird sleep last night. I felt like when I woke up, I was still just extremely just out. I don't know. It was very strange. I guess our dog started kind of getting a little restless around 6:30 this morning. And I remember that happening, but I had no clue what time it was. So happy second Tuesday, Charles. Morning to you. Charles, I thought of you this morning, and I've been thinking of you because you called my flavored coffees. You called them frou-frou coffees, and I can't get it out of my head now. Every time I go to the make some coffee this of the flavored variety, I'm like, well, time to have my frou-frou. So, I don't know, that's just who I am now, I guess. I don't know. So. Tips the coffee. Cheers. I also, I will get a sip here. I combine them a little bit here. I didn't quite have enough of the salty siren left. So I actually threw a tablespoon of Folgers on top of it just to make it a little bit more bold flavored. So we'll see if it turned out okay. It's about using the shift key on your typewriter to lift the letter. You haven't? Well, I hope that you enjoy it today, Ursa. I've been enjoying the heck out of the game. And it's been it's not a perfect game. Like, I'll be totally honest with you, it's not a perfect game, but it is also still an early access game too. So yeah. 3 work days until my sabbatical. Wait, how long is that going to be, Lady Iron? Bourgeoisie cafe. I don't know how to say that word either. I know what it means, but I don't know that I'm really bougie myself. So. Nothing wrong with flavored coffee. I mean, I normally don't go for flavored coffee, but this one, it's been solid overall. So. Hey, good morning, Woodsy. How are you feeling today? Add a tablespoon of mocha powder to it before brewing. Then a dollop of fresh whipped cream. Really? Sounds pretty good. You're so posh, Lutz. 6 weeks? Oh, really? Dang, where do I sign up? Thought of you when I was picking up some coffee Sunday too, Lutz. Half the selection I skip over because it's all frou-frou. what's your go-to, Charles? Have we talked about that before? I only drink tea and lift my pinky finger up while holding the China cup. Well, I mean, that makes sense. You're from the UK, so everybody there is extremely fancy. Come work for my company, Lutz. You got any developers? Are you hiring any developers? Also, does everybody get a 6-week sabbatical? Hit a new record yesterday with Instacart and got $80 redos worth of groceries for free from messed up address. Wait, really? How does this keeps happening to you, Woodsy? You think they'll ever figure it out? I want sabbatical. I know, right? Sounds awesome. I like light roast, like Wegmans. Is it Wegmans? Wegmans breakfast blend? I've never had that. And I actually don't, I don't, it's been a while since I've had a light roast. Maybe I should try another one. I'm not from the UK. How very dare you, Lutz? I'm sorry. Okay, you're from across the pond. I should say that. Compared to Americans, you're all very fancy to us. Everyone gets one every 4 years of service. And yes, we are hiring devs. Wow. Every 4 years of service. So I'd be on my second one. I just finished my 8th year with the company. I am now beginning year 9 as of the end of July. That's the first free food I've gotten in over 100 orders. I'm happy, though. Dang. That is impressive. 6 weeks, that's a normal holiday amount if you live somewhere civilized. 6 weeks straight. Just had a job opening up on our data conversion team. Anyone knows SQL? DM me. Shoot, I haven't used SQL in ages. I'm about to brush up on it a little bit. Just for a personal project. Then again, I might not. I was thinking about going SQL-less. Thinking about going, I don't know yet. I still have to decide. But had to have several glugs of coffee before I got that joke. Our company offers sabbaticals too. It's called retirement. Yeah, same, same. Scratch his belly button. You're one of them fancy pants Europeans. You must be one of them there fancy pantses. You have to get pregnant to get 6 weeks in the yeah. And even still, that's not a guarantee. But yeah, I don't know. That sounds nice. I am probably not going to take very much time off between now and our vacation that we have booked, which is in mid-November. Probably will not have much time off between now and then. Which is, you know, it's fine. The fall season is, I would like to take a week in. I love October. It's one of the few months of the year, generally speaking, where I can say I truly love where I live. Just from a climate perspective. Because fall in the Midwest is chef's kiss. So good. Then they try and get you to work from home, right? My last job, I got 26 days holiday, 9 bank holidays, 18 flexible working days, and unlimited sickness. Dang. That's pretty solid there, Jersey. My company is on an MTO plan, or managed time off plan, which basically, it essentially means unlimited time off. So, yeah, it's cool. I don't like count any of my days necessarily. I've counted them. I've been keeping track just because I'm kind of curious, because before that it was 5 weeks holiday. So it was 25 days of holiday. Plus, you know, all the standard our bank holidays. I think we have like 5 or 6. So still less. But then we have 3 floating holidays. So still less than you had, Jersey, but not bad. Not bad. And sick days, I don't remember what our company policy was on sickness. I've taken, in 8 years, I've taken 1 sick day, I want to say, just because, generally speaking, if I'm sick, I can still work from home. But I did have one day I was having some really bad vertigo, and I was like, I don't want to look at my monitor. I'm just going to sleep. So I took a sick day that day. But how you doing, Swida? Yo, yo. Like a tiny larva sucking on my teats. I'm not interested in answering emails. Tiny larva. That's your new signature. I think our company does legit offer sabbaticals, but I don't know how anyone is ever able to do it. Schedules, yeah, and such. Exactly. Iconic, right. The imagery. Larva, teats, get out of my head. That's a permanent resident now. The imagery. Just a larva. Oh, friends, I am very excited to announce that I have a haircut tonight. I'm going to see my barber, and I'm looking forward to that because I needs it. But other than that, today the plan is to play some more V Rising, my friends. We're doing a little bit of a symmetrical week. So we've got Dinkum Monday and Friday. V Rising Tuesday, Thursday, and then A Tale of Paper and Raft on Wednesday. So, Juan the barber. yes. Although no, not Juan. Oh, that's funny. Oh, that was, when was that? Was that on my birthday? I think that was my birthday stream last year, right? If you get signed off by the doctor over here, you're legally forbidden from undertaking any form of work at all. Really? Is it? I guess that makes sense. We had some furloughs during COVID, and we were legally forbidden from working at all as well during the furlough. So I guess that's because then the company could get in huge trouble. It's accurate, though. They're so wrinkly and alien at first, sucking literal life from our bodies. That is rather, rather, what's the word I'm looking for? Just dark, I guess. Rather morbid, but not incorrect at the same time. So, yeah, go see Juan tonight. Juan, the cousin who speaks no English. No. My barber is actually Puerto Rican, though, and his native language is Spanish, but he's very good at English. So, definitely way better at English than I am Spanish. That's for dang sure. So. All right, my friends, how about we get into some V Rising today? Let's see what's on the docket. I believe what we did last time, we unlocked some iron, not to be confused with iron. We unlocked iron, but I didn't actually have enough time to smelt it. It takes a long time to smelt. So I'm either going to need to make more furnaces or, I'm just going to have to be more patient, I guess. But I have nipples, Greg. Can you milk me? Can anybody else name the movie? It's a fantastic movie. I should rewatch it. I have not seen that in years. In Germany, if you're on holiday, the company is prevented from contacting you except in extreme emergency. In Germany. Yes, I take a long time to smelt. That's quite a euphemism there. I'm trying to think of also Meet the Parents. Yeah, I really need to rewatch that. It's been a long time. A long time. 5 bars? What did I need? 12? 12 bars, I think it was, for this throne. And we'll get to the next part of the story or whatever you want to call it. 16. Okay, so I've got a little bit to wait. I asked BB yesterday if I could not work so I could stay home to raise our babies. He said yes. Oh, yeah. Dang. Look at that. You're gonna be living the life. If you don't mind me asking, Koro, and please tell me if you don't want to answer, but do you have plans for kids in the near future? Mrs. Magoots and I have talked more about it, but we still don't really have plans. What is this one? This garden is so funny. It's just so unorganized. I actually kind of like the mixing of the frost and fire, but I think I want it to be a little bit more balanced than that. 2-3-1-1-1. I don't know. Maybe a little more balanced. Also, I really wish I could make more glass because, wow, that looks so good. Oh, gotta murder some wolves. Game's lagging a little bit today. I currently have worker blood. Oh, right, because I still have it left over from when I was grabbing the iron, and it does make a difference. Actually does, if you can believe it. Yeah, how long does this take each time? So you were almost ready to find out. $2.24 per bar. Jeez. By the way, Coral, Mrs. Cheese was in your neck of the woods this last weekend. Visited some friends who have a house on Lake Harrington. Harrington. How far away is that from you, Charles? Did she drive or fly? You can't befriend the wolves. No, unfortunately not. Unfortunately not. We've kind of befriended this moose, but that's only because we're magically intertwined now. I still have yet to make a video on Megan the Moose. I need to do that. Not the near future, but someday I want to adopt one and birth one. Ah, very noble of you. Very noble indeed. This window is wide open. What do I need to make windows again? Windows, glass windows, four glasses. Okay. Adopting and birthing. Oh, glass is a different recipe for quartz. Okay. Maybe I can find out. Nikolaus the Fallen's who we're tracking right now. Not glass. Who teaches us glass? We don't know. Wait, oh, gear level's too low because I'm not. I was gonna say, I've seen these people before. That's why I didn't have my sword out. Okay. Christina the Sun Priestess teaches us glass. I've seen Christina the Sun Priestess. She was north in the land of Scary. Blue, it's about a 10 to 11 hour drive for us over the mountains. Gotcha. I want to meet Mrs. Cheese. Well, you should have been near Lake. You should have been at Lake Harrington, I guess. Me too. She must be a saint. Let my real wife meet my work wife. That'd be like crossing the beams. Total platonic reversal. That's funny. One sec. Gosh. Oh, track kids are goofy. All right. Yeah, so we'll have Nikolaus the Fallen here in a second, but I wanted to see if I could make this throne first. Almost. In just of 1 minute, we can. And she's way hotter than me, so it's fine. Never had a work wife. Not really. I mean, I work in a an extremely male dominated field, which is like, you know, it's whatever. But never had anybody. I mean, due to that fact, I never had anybody that I could consider a work wife. Oh, shoot. I still have a lot of crap in my inventory. I was going to make this the throne room. It turns out the throne is massive. I had no idea. So really what I need to do at some point is just upgrade this heart and I can make a real throne room at some point. But I need 24 glass and 24 iron ingots. The ingots are whatever. I can get those. But the glass? I have to go kill Christina for that. It's going to take a while. All right. This is just enough to make the throne. But I can command my servant. And so I'm excited to see. I remember watching a short video from Code Carnage on like tips when you're starting out in V-Rising. And I'm pretty sure one of the tips, I don't remember anything else, but I'm pretty sure one of the tips was get a servant as soon as possible. And we had just the perfect amount of iron. That's just so fortunate. All right. Dominance. K. Castle Throne. There it is. Command your servant from the Castle Throne. What? Oh, this is interesting. I just tell him where to go and he'll do it. I'm a little worried about this, though, because I don't know if he just teleports or what. Okay, let's click on a fairly easy-ish one. Maybe the logging. Maybe this armory to start. Wait, oh, no, that's led by the quartermaster. Okay, hang on. Oh, interesting. Okay. I don't have any servants active because they're dead. Okay, let me wake him up first. Technology unlocked the Eye of Twilight. Okay. Eye of Twilight. Construct and interact with the Eye of Twilight. Imperious wall panels? Vampires fight each other for these powerful artifacts. This device shall guide me. Oh, there it is. The Eye of Twilight. I need 4 gold ingots and 4 spectral dusts. Holy crap. That is going to be an eternity until I get there. Okay, I gotta go get Blood Essence to resurrect Elliot. Gets in this bin. Hopefully he just teleports, because again, he'd have to walk by Megan the Moose and the two of them have an eternal conflict. He'll try to kill her. Or him. Really, Megan's a he. Megan's a he and Elliot is a she. Alright. Resurrecting. That's why there's this servant door right there, so they can't ever meet again, if at all possible. Arise, Elliot. Also, let's take a look at your gear. Merciless Night Stalker. Oh, wait a minute. Hang on. What do I have of Merciless Night Stalker? Oh, a Night Stalker vest. Okay. I could make that for Elliot. Also, Blood Ring. I don't have anything better than that. And a Copper Spear. Okay. Because all I have is Merciless Copper. Okay. All right. I can't make... What does Merciless Copper need? Hang on. Let's go see. Merciless Night Stalker Vest. Merciless Copper... Oh, I could make that. I could make that. That's 3 more levels. Okay. Oh, but they have a spear, not a sword. Okay. Well, I could still make that. Crude sapphires, whetstones, and leather. Also, I should move around the castle faster. I don't know what's wrong with me. All right. Crude sapphires, 8 whetstones. Yeah, we can definitely do that. Leather out here. Crude sapphires. It was 2 of them. Leather in here. Somewhere in here. There they are. Crude sapphires. Okay. And then I'll need coppers, and I think I still have planks. So copper ingots. Go. Okay, so we'll make a sword. I don't remember what I need for the Merciless Night Stalker, whatever, but because I can't even remember which one it was. They have a Gravedigger Ring, Ember Chain. I can't make an Ember Chain because I don't have any greater blood essence, but I could maybe make a Gravedigger Ring. Anyway, well, let's make the copper sword. And then let's go see which merciless one they need. Where'd you go, Elliot? There you are. Okay, so they need the vest. I'll actually take that. The vest. What do they wear instead? Looks the same. I think their gear is just for levels, not actually. Yeah. Okay. Let's make this other merciless copper sword. Perfect. Okay. And then merciless night stalker vest. I need 4 coarse threads. Oh, and I'm short on copper ingots. Burned up pretty quick. All right, so I'll have copper ingots here and then coarse threads. We have a few of those. All right. Oh, so there's going to be a solid amount of crafting for your companions, like, all the time. I said companions, but that's not right. They're servants. Companions. All right, so we have that, and then the merciless night stalker sword. Oh, shoot. Okay. I'll take the copper spear back. Okay. Gear level is 32 now. 32, up from 28. Seems maybe like a little bit of a ripoff, but it is what it is. Okay, so let's try to send Elliot out. Wait a minute. Actually, hang on. The grave ring? It was 8 grave dust and 40 morning lilies, I think. They have 6 here. Could easily make more, though. That was another 3 levels, so be up to 35. That's solid. Then I'll know that Elliot is maxed out. So let's do that. Let's do that. All right. Yes. Hopefully I have. Then again, hopefully I have morning lilies. I don't know if I have that many. 40. Oh, we have plenty. Okay. We're good. What on earth is this? Book Punk? New Kofi sub from Book Punk? Whoa, what's going on? Book Punk, are you there? Are you there, my friend? Can I give you a massive cheers up for the Kofi support? I don't know if you're here or not, but holy crap, my friend. Cheers. Howdy from Texas. There you are. Cheers. Thank you so much for that, my friend. How the heck are you? Elliot is live for once. Yes, for once. For once. I have 7. Okay, and here is 8. Perfect. Wait, how much does grave dust cost? Oh, it's only 75 now. That's pretty cool. Thank you so much for that, Book Punk. Hope you're having a good day. I don't want to butcher this name. Cheers. I would almost say Shinsuke. Shinsuke. Cheers. I actually had a Demon Slayer fan. Thank you so much for the follow. Cheers. I actually had a Japanese student athlete that spelled his name very similar to that. And he went by Shinsuke. So I didn't know if I was close or not. Awake barely, clean, right out of the shower and in search of caffeine. Oh, what are we going to get for our caffeine dosage here? Are we going to get some coffee? Let's make the Gravedigger ring. So I have an extra Blood Rose ring, you know, whatever, I guess, but don't really watch anime. That's all good. All good. I actually don't really watch anime either, my friend. Koro's just a huge nerd. No, I'm just kidding. Wolfie? White Monster Zero Energy or Energy Zero Ultra. Energy Zero Ultra. Man, that is a mouthful. All right, Elliot's level 35, maxed out. I cannot do Elliot any better right now. So let's command Elliot, see what we can do. Just go to a random, let's see, there was a sulfur one. Sulfur is, I think, on the far left, but let's see, there's also paper there. Is there paper here? Let's try this one, Bandit Stronghold. Oh, you can add up to three here. Okay. So maybe chance of injury 20%. Okay. Are all of these the same? Hunt duration 23. Wait, is that hours? 23 hours? Holy crapola. I'm like never gonna be able to finish one of these. 23 in-game hours is an eternity. All right, let's try to add Elliot. Success chance 44%. Okay, let's not do that one then. And switch. Okay, success chance is just 44%. Because I probably need more servants. Are there any others that... Okay, this one's 100% chance. Sawdust, lumber, coarse thread, blood essence. I mean, I'll never need lumber again. General area loot. Okay. Oh, gosh.
From the window to the wall, to the wall. Till the meat spills out my hall,
my hall.
Oh, these Vikings crawl, crawl. Ow, ski, 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 ski. Ow, ski, ski.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Ow, ski, 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 ski. Ow, ski, ski.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Moro throwing us a party out here. No, literally, I am. I was just messing around, Koro. We're all nerds around here. Give you a cheers up for that. Love your streaming personally. I appreciate that, my friend. Seriously. Cobra, how the heck are you? It's going well. How about you, my friend? Michelle, good morning. Good morning, good morning. Things are all good here. I guess I just realized I'm kind of blocking this panel for you guys, but this so far I've seen a very low chance of success. Oh, that one's 100% chance. That's pretty cool. Lots of sulfur ore, fire blossom, clay. Okay, yeah, let's do this one. But it's going to take 23 hours. Like, my gosh. So wait a minute, does this say like attack, how much attack power it needs? Oh, it does. Okay, so it needs 400. And what does Elliot have? 320 some? That one's 500, 450, 500. Yeah, 324. Okay. That's interesting. So this is really my best option over here for things that I actually need and success chance. Hunt and Bandit Sulfur Quarry started. Okay. Does Elliot just disappear? I guess. I don't see Elliot walking through the castle. Okay, that's good then. That's actually really good. Can I see the progress then? It is, in fact, 23 hours, and I'm assuming it's in-game hours. I guess we'll find out, but it has to be in-game hours, which kind of sucks because really I would need... This time is, it's probably similar to Valheim, right? Like, as long as somebody was in the server, the time would continue running. Then again, your blood, like, yeah. You can't just leave this game sitting overnight. You'll keep dying because of your blood. That is going to be an actual eternity. An actual eternity. Okay, well, let's go after Nikolaus then, I suppose. That's what we should do. Oh, but first my inventory, and then I can, then I can teleport. All right. Compulsively count. on all these boxes real fast. Start them off, grab a steaming cup of blood, and get on with what you were doing. A steaming cup of blood. Mmm. I got me hung up for a second. Mm-mm. 23 hours are going to pass anyway. Oh, they will? Even if I'm not in game? Because that would be great. That would be incredible, in fact. Let's see. Anything else? Yeah, I have quartz. I just can't make glass out of it, unfortunately. All right, we got lots of these. I'll put the stone bricks and other stuff in stone bodies in here. And planks go in there. Okay. I'm gonna play 23 more hours anyway. Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, true. True. I just need to get like multiple servants. It's just gonna take me a long time to hit 23 hours. Because I only play this game, you know, like a couple hours at a time. Okay. Wait a minute. Put those in there too. Okay, that is full. All right. And then two pieces of logs. I wonder if there's any way you can speed it up. Maybe I need to just install some mods or something. I don't know. Because it's definitely, I can tell this game is definitely more meant for a persistent server with lots of activity. If you do that, this game ends up, like, you can make crazy good progress in it, but that's not really how I'm playing currently. Okay, I don't know where this guy is, though, so me teleporting might not really mean a lot. Is he... Let me go read about him. Might be that he's in, like, a graveyard. A necromancer driven out of high society in Silverlight for his indulgence in the dark arts. Now he lives among the undead, using his unliving servants to fill his needs, as well as bring him back unwilling subjects for his experiments. Okay, that makes sense. Although, another thing I have not done very well is prepare myself. I'm terrible about preparing. I could use an enchanted brew and a brew of ferocity. Mm-hmm. Oops. Oh, no, this. There we go. Fire blossoms. There we go. Okay. Should be able to make them now. Wait, what am I missing? Oh, Hell's Clarion. I grabbed not the Hell's Clarion instead. Okay. There we go. All right. Let's make one of each of these. All right. We'll get those potions ready. Necromancer? I barely know her. Ooh. Necromancer always makes me think. My first thought whenever I hear the word necromancer is like Black Soul Gems from Oblivion. I don't know why. That's my first thing. You were grabbing for the salt and oops, you grabbed the Hell's Clarion. Simple mistake. Accidentally grabbed the Hell's Clarion. Just a dash of pepper. Oops. Hell's Clarion. All right, these should be done now. Indeed they are. Okay. So, Nikolaus the Fallen, it looks like, is in the northwest direction? No. Southeast direction. Okay. Exact opposite. Southeast. There's a forgotten cemetery right here. You know what? That's probably it. I don't really go into the cemeteries too often, but that's definitely the biggest one. Probably in the Forgotten Cemetery, so I'm not even going to teleport there. Have to run to a meeting? No worries, no worries. You always think of Malkoran from Skyrim? We're kind of in the same mode of thought, though. No, stop. I'm a wolf like you. Also, I realized I've wasted too much time today, and now I gotta... Well, that's fine. I gotta go get some blood. I don't know what blow would be the best. Ooh, 35%? Nah. I love how they're circling around me. Do they always do that? What in the world? Do they always do this? And on that day, my wolf pack grew by 2. Uh-oh. Woo! Oh, my game was about to lag out. Oh, it might. Definitely lagging a lot more than usual. Just looking for a high quality blood. I don't really care what type it is at this point. Oh. I can kind of head towards the Forgotten Cemetery in the meantime. He's the Necromancer in Meridia's Temple. Gotcha. Okay. Malkoran. The name sounds familiar, but I have not played Skyrim in such a long time now. I've definitely been getting the itch to get back into it, but I probably have not played Skyrim. Probably haven't even booted the game up in ...8 years. It's been a long time. Okay, that all that blood sucks. Worker blood is not really super helpful for fighting bosses. It's great for like mining, but there's some sulfur. And again, do I need, I probably don't really care, do I? I don't know. Eh, what the heck? These are level 34s. When did they get so strong? I'm stuck. Don't like this. Wow, I got knocked down. Jeez. Okay. Well, the good thing is I'm only dropping 2 things and I'm also very close to where I'm going to respawn, but wow, I got super stuck there. Also, is Nikolaus even here? Is there sunlight coming through here? Really hard to tell with this color. Wow, that was terrible. I'm gonna have bad blood too. All right, well, crapola. Yeah, that cemetery was a lot more difficult than the last one I was in. The last one I could just kind of do whatever. Wasn't a big deal. All right, I never use these, so I'm just going to go grab one just because. I've got a, I've got a sun resistance potion just sitting in here. Because baby, now we got bad blood. I do though, I'm 0% blood. Like a peon. I should have turned into a bear, maybe. I don't know. I keep forgetting too, I don't need bombs anymore for the bear form. I can just go knock down that. Knock down that gate. Oh, it's a Trant. Oh, I really do wish there was some way to learn better, like, skills. Uh-oh. Yo, good thing I had that sun resistance brew. Like, I feel like making gear is one thing, but, like, having skills and experience points and whatever would allow me to progress a little bit, but... Of course, it's not possible. Like computer hacking skills, bow hunting skills, nunchuck skills. There are some of boyfriends who have great skills. You know, can I admit something to you, Lady Iron? When I first saw that movie, I was like, I don't get what the big deal is. I don't know why everybody likes this so much. It is awfully shaded in here. But I watched it later again and I was like, oh no, this is the like one of the most amazing movies I've ever seen. What are these? Skeleton mage. Oh, there's grave dust inside of those. That's pretty nice. How to draw a liger, perhaps. Tina, come get some ham. Tina, you fat lard. Come and get some dinner. I don't know what it was, but I did not really like the movie. I thought it was overhyped. It was actually similar to Superbad was similar. I saw Superbad in theaters, but everybody had been quoting it for like a week at that point before I could go and see it. And I was like, man, everybody said like all the lines already. That was one part of it, I think, but. Yeah, it actually is an amazing, amazing movie. Have you all seen my you have all seen my Nacho Libre cosplay? No, no. Come again, please. What is this? I feel like we need to see it now. Ooh, what's down here? Huh. Okay. What, Koro? No, but now we have to, right? Right? How long ago was this? Let's see. Skeleton mage, armored skeleton. Okay, so there are two skeleton mages. What? Oh, wow. Okay, did not realize that skeleton mage was there. Thought that was, I don't know what that, I thought that was. Right, we'll transform into the bear just so we heal up a little better. How? Wait, what do you mean how? How have we not seen it? No, you tell us. You tell us. Okay, Nikolaus is probably towards the center here. This is a really bad idea. I have no blood. Can I not get morning lilies? Guess not. Okay, let me heal up. What do I do? 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 I don't know what to do. In the Discord now? Okay, we gotta take a look at this. I can't pause the game. Wish I could. 17 in the first pick and 20 in the second. That was the text I saw in the preview here. Wow. This is amazing. Incredible. Incredible. Yeah, you guys got to check that out in the Discord when you get a chance. It is V good. V good. Oh, I think I have to go find some blood. I don't think I can do this. I would have been okay with the worker blood, but not this. This is going to be rather upsetting, I think. I do think we found him. I think we found a path to him. It's solid. I just got to find something. Do a stream in that costume? Yes, I agree. Oh, look, Militia Brawler. I hate that their blood is so low. It would take me so much effort to be able to kill one of those and like a perfect battle. And it gives me 16% blood. I'm just going to end up snagging one of these, though, over here. Take Deadeye or Rogue Blood, I guess. Just so I'm not empty. But it's rather bad. If I can find something better real quick. 33% is better. Okay, we'll do that. And that's on the poacher, so I gotta be real careful here. Woo! I better feed now. We got the better blood. Go ahead and leave. Ooh, good shot. All right. Should be okay now. 33% rogue blood is not great, but it's definitely better than barely any 0% blood. So hopefully not everybody respawned. We'll be fine. I'll heal up a little bit and we'll try to take down Nikolaus. I've also got potions to drink too. I'm assuming he's up at the top here, but I don't know. I need to heal up first. So we'll take a little rest. Nikolaus the Fallen. The last boss I fought was what? Quincy the Bandit King? Wasn't so bad. Really wasn't bad at all. It was nice that he was pretty much alone. Rigor Mortis came to bring you good luck. Well, welcome in. I could use some good luck. Thank you so much for the follow. Cheers to you. Cheers, my new friend. Welcome in. Yeah, I'm just trying to heal up as a bear real quick. I'm going to see if I can maybe smack Nikolaus the Fallen a good one or two. Almost at full health. Very close. Nikolaus the Fallen. Creepy little necromancer guy. All right, here we go. I think he'll be up here, but I don't actually know for sure. Oh, no, that's him right there, right? Or is that just regular skeleton priests? Ah, okay. How do I guess I have to go this way. Okay, that's really weird. I don't know, for some odd reason. Oh gosh. A year and 3 months? Thanks so much for that, True Celt. My goodness, my friend. I apologize. I am in the thick of things right now. Oh, wow. I missed everything there. I gotta go after the mages. There we go. Eh. Don't likey this. About to die. There's just so many of them. So many things. Am I not healing because I'm in a fight right now? I don't seem to be healing here. Whew. Love the username. Thank you so much for that, True Kelt. Cheers to you, my good friend. A year and 3 months indeed. My goodness. Cheers. How the heck are ya? How's your day treating you thus far? I'm also doing extremely poorly in my combat today. Like, extremely poorly. Rigor Mortis, are you a fan of V Rising? That was an excruciatingly bad fight on my part. I did terribly. I was trying to save this potion until a little later, but I guess I should just drink it now, shouldn't I? Both of them. Both Ferocity and Enchanted. Because it's for 20 minutes or whatever? Yeah, it's for 20 minutes. In theory, it can help more than one battle. So, Lady Iron, enjoy the lurk. No, you've never heard of it? Really? Okay. What kind of games do you enjoy most? What are some of your faves? Since I get a little bit of a movement speed boost, but in a higher chance for crits, I don't know. Just, I feel like I never noticed my movement speed actually increasing. It's kind of sad. Went through a death phase. Wait, what? A death phase? All right, let's drink. Well, I'm good in my inventory. 5 grave dust is pretty solid. Actually useful. Hopefully this graveyard does stay in shadows. This other area, because I didn't want to. I'm not hoping these guys aren't going to respawn, because this has actually been a pretty tough fight for me so far, which is kind of sad. I feel like I should be able to handle a lot easier than this, but I'm just playing terribly. Drinking potions as a bear. That's pretty sick. Pretty sick. All right. I gotta find those, Yeah, the skeleton priests, they gotta go first. They're the ones that summon all the extras. How did that miss? There we go. Okay, got the other skeleton priest. Now the mages are also kind of tough. Tough as in, like, they take a pretty good beating here. There we go. All right. Yeah, that was a lot easier when I got rid of the dang priest. The dang priest. All right. Anybody else? Oh, there's another troop over there. Destroy all their plans. Yeah. No more necromancy over here. Skyrim and survival games. Oh, we're gonna get along great then. We're gonna get along great. Extremely curious about death and dying, so did a lot of reading about it. Wait, where's this coming from, Cora? Did I say something that I have already forgotten about? Because that's extremely possible. I do that all the time. Okay, I think I gotta take out. Are there two skeleton priests? Son of a gun. Okay. Honk! Honk! Okay, we got them both. Woo! That was good. Yeah, that fight went well. That went well. Okay. So hopefully they won't infringe on the fight that we're gonna have here coming up soon. Hey, what's going on, Peachy? First honk of the day. I was curious who might have honked at me. You know what? I honk at you, my friend. Honk. I honk at you. Oh, rigor mortis. Okay, the name rigor mortis. Got it. Okay. I was like, wait, where is this coming from, Koro? I mean, it's okay. I was left behind somehow. Well, you can step on spiders. That's what the squishy sound comes from. All right. Let's go back into a bear. A little bit more healing. I'm assuming Nikolaus is at the top of this staircase. Moe, hey, how are you, Moe? And Terry? Welcome in, you two. Moe, how's life been treating you? Terry, how are the fur noodles? Rigor mortis is what happens when you die in your body 7. Yeah, exactly, exactly. I just didn't realize that that was what started it. That's all. Yeah, there's Nikolaus. I see him right there. Okay, we still got our potions active. Seems like, well, as long as he doesn't summon too many undeads, we might be okay. One thing that might be a good idea is going on the other side of this raised area, making sure nobody's gonna interfere on this side. They were very naughty last night, but they're doing good. Good to hear that. Come on, I feel like that should have killed them all. There we go. The bear form is fun. It's just fun. I still haven't really figured out too many practical uses for it, but it's fun. So what were they doing last night that was naughty? They just not listening? All right. Okay, here we go, my friends. It seems like we're going to be in a decent amount of mist here. I don't see any direct sunlight. So, here we go.
And what are you? A new fan. You couldn't possibly get up.
Try to hit him with my ultimate. It takes a long time for the ultimate to come back. Okay. I think I hit him. I'm not actually sure, though. He kind of moves around a lot. That's the only downside. Bullet hell here. See, like that? Lots of bones laying around. Oh, wow. Lots of enemies he just spawned there. Oh, what? He hit me with that? Dang. Dang, lots of enemies. Holy jeez.
Your bones will be mine.
Oh. Wow, that really hit me? Come on, we were doing so well. Please don't fall apart now. Oh no, come on! Dang, he keeps using that attack. I've not been able to get in very close lately. Oh no, I got stuck! Come on, get close. Come on, game. Come on. Please don't do this. Ah. Yes, let's freaking go. Woo-hoo-hoo. Oh, no. Moe, did you? You didn't even post a link, did you? I bet you didn't even post a link. Yes, let's go. Let's go. Nice. Very nice. Lots of stuff to pick up, too. Holy crap. Woo, I'm shaking. I'm shaking. The boss fights are tough. I just constantly am so shaky afterwards. Just so nerve-wracking, because I felt like I was absolutely killing it at the beginning, and every time I fight, like, I start doing worse and worse the longer the fight goes. Cheers. Thank you for that. Let's see. Is it Mr. Selu TV? Cheers. Or is it Mercelu TV? Or either, you know, or something in between. Cheers. Thank you for that follow, my new friend. Hope you're having a great day. Just working a lot. How you doing? Pretty much the same, actually, Moe. Working a lot as well. We've got a new product that's supposed to be rolling out at the end of this month, and it has me in a bit of a crunch here. But, It's been a mostly successful crunch for what it's worth. Okay, so bring this to a research desk to unlock. Okay. All right. So that was Nikolaus the Fallen. And what powers did we get? I assume it's going to be an unholy ward of the damned. Increased movement speed by 10%, block melee and projectile attacks in front of you. Is that? No, it's this one. Pestilence. Launch a wave of three unholy projectiles that each deal 40% magic damage, knocks target back and inflict amplify, and increases damage taken by 25% for 5 seconds. That's actually, 5 seconds is not bad. I didn't figure you posted a link. Sorry about that, Moe. So they stole and chewed up my husband's new Vortex paint mixer. Wait, really? Man, did they all collude on that or something? Oh, I've never seen a bear jump like that before, thankfully. All right, let's get the heck out of this graveyard. It's definitely been long enough. I was gonna say, it's definitely been long enough for some respawns by now. But we're just going to go ahead and GTFO. H. My chonky butts running right on out of there, and they can't even keep up. Impressive. I was not healing the whole time, though. I guess the healing in combat is a no-go. That's a no-go. They work together to move heavier objects. Are these still the same? Yeah. The machine itself is hopefully fine, but the top part, which is silicon, was chewed. Dang. Chonky butt, yes. Look at my chonky butt. Kind of cute, though, not gonna lie. Wait a minute, did the bear really just scare the... Wow, okay. I thought I could maybe... Thought maybe I could transform. Like, back to a vampire just by trying to fish, but no, it just swings its giant bear paw. We do need fat gobies, actually. I need fish bones for my potions. But I thought it would just go ahead and cast out the fishing pole as I turn back into a vampire, but no, it just swings a giant bear paw and scares the fish away. Go wolf form this time. Now that we're healed. Eventually we're going to build the castle up on this bit here. I'm pretty excited about that. More castle up here, but I got to get rid of the stone golem at some point to do that. I don't know if I've killed one of those yet. I don't think I have. Okay. We're back home. Let's see everything that we did actually get from Nikolaus. Oh, so we did get Ward of the Damned as well. Okay. And then a study That is actually going to be really useful. So I got to get more papers. How many papers do I have currently? 31. So, okay. I need another 7 papers. Merciless Iron Reaper? Wait a minute. Oh, because that's... I need to study for that, obviously. Okay. So how about this Frozen Eye? It's a... Oh, it's a ring. Okay. Okay. Is it a good one? Have a good stream. Appreciate it, Terry. You have a good day as well. Frozen Eye is also 12. 12. Okay. And a Mist Signet. They're the same. Okay. They're all the same gear level. Have a good day, all you as well, Terry. Thanks for stopping in, my friend. How am I doing on time here? I got a meeting at 11 a.m. today. The Greater Blood Essence. Oh, it's only one. So that's good. I guess they're all only one. So it just depends on if you want sapphires, mist stones, or emeralds. And then this is spell critical strike chance, stun resistance rating, and cooldowns, max health and movement speed. And I'm, you know, it's only 4% movement speed boost, but I'm, as you all know, that's kind of my go-to. Kind of my go-to. All right.
Hello there.
Hello there, True Celt. Been fighting fires at work. No worries. No worries. Hope things are okay, my friend. Hope things are all mkoy. Wait, clay? Have I been? I don't know that I've been storing clay in there. I think I've been storing clay. No, never mind. I was right. I'd say hello there before resubbing, but hey, look, more fires to fight. No, you're good. You're all good, my friend. Things are settling in. It's not too hectic. Like real fires? Because that seems like a bit much for a Tuesday morning before the coffee's even hit. Doesn't it? I assume they are not literal fires. I think we're more figuratively speaking here. But I know the concept, at least. We've definitely had those issues ourselves. I have 8 fat gobies now, so that's 8 fish bones. Twilight Snapper. Okay. There's gonna be a way to get more data load fires. Oh, shoot. Yeah. Oop. Nah, that's not what I meant to do. Gosh dang it. Gosh dang it, Lutz. You dummy. Those aren't supposed to go in there either. Okay. Now we sort them. Okay. Data Load Fire sounds like a band name. I'm for it, but I hope everything's good now. Agreed. Agreed on both the band name and the hope things are all good. Okay, we almost got the inventory sorted already. That's like a new record. It's like a new record. All right. Well, cool. I think the next boss is kind of out of our range now. Beatrice the Tailor, I'm also level 38. So, I mean, we could, but I think a better use of time right now. So we can make a loom at some point. Okay. I actually think I have enough wool threads to make it. So that's pretty cool. And turning into human form would be pretty cool. That'll be pretty cool. So Beatrice the Tailor would be a good one to go for, but I'm guessing Beatrice is going to be north again, which is kind of very scary. Speaking of band names, I saw a fellow at the girls' swim school wearing a mouse rat t-shirt. I commented on it. No way. That's awesome. Mouse rat. That would be, I'm sure that was an amazing shirt. I've seen a couple. What I see, I saw like the whole, Run for the Cure, like Michael Scott's memorial race. That whole long name. I've seen those shirts before. They're pretty good too. Yeah, I think I'm better off trying to build this study. So I got to get, what, 7 more papers? 7 more papers. I think that's what I should do. So we'll hit up all these other small bandit camps because they all have papers. I am running out of daylight or nightlight, I should say. Oh, yes, I had a Michael Scott Race for the Cure t-shirt and rubber bracelet. Nice. One of the bracelets as well. That's fantastic. Any good bloods over here? Not really. Some of them might have paper on them. Oh, that one had paper. There we go. Oh, that deer had 40% creature blood. That's solid. It is solid. Okay, I'm probably only going to have enough time for this one camp before the sun comes up. Just trying to see. There's a 30. Oh, 100% rogue blood. Yes, please. We'll be taking that. Means I can't really use any powers until I've already fed on this one. Got it. 100%, baby. That's only the second time I've ever had that. Come here.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Dr. D! How are you doing today, my friend? There's a few papers in here. Oh, there's a whole troop over here as well. Yeah, I think we might actually have gotten all the papers we needed. It's in this one camp. Doing okay? Arm is really bugging me after work last night. Oh, really? You said it was your first day back? See, actually, might have been 6 papers instead of 7. What? Forge flooring? I think I already have that, right? So that might actually be all the papers I need then. Because that's basically like finding 10 papers. Yeah, I had 6. Okay. A piece of glass? Ooh. Unfortunately, I need 4 glasses per window, but yeah, shoot. Hopefully it's not going to be too bad. Arm is really bugging me. Oh, do you think it'll heal up quick? I hope. I already have forge flooring, right? No, I don't have forge flooring, do I? I have like the other one. Whatever this is not forge floor. This is a workshop floor. Okay, so this is new. This is not enough pages then. I'm 1 paper short. 1 paper short. Okay. Oh, this is actually a good one. We needed this. Hey, what's going on, Phil? And Dr. D, my friend. Thanks so much for the 100 gold coins. Cheers to you. Cheers. Phil, how are you? How you doing today? This is brand new. Seriously appreciate that, though, Dr. D. I really hope that the shoulder heals up quickly. Maybe it'll be just be a matter of like getting readjusted to work and then it'll be right as rain. That's my hope for you. Sometimes we tend to hurt a little bit before things get better. Hopefully that's all it is. And lumber. What have I been doing with the lumber? I've been putting it in here. I guess so. Okay. All right. So forge flooring, that's going to help. But I didn't really want to keep my furnaces in here. I think I'll move them over here. What does this require? Taylor's floor. Okay. Okay. Not bad. School started again, so I can't get up at 13 o'clock anymore. 13 o'clock, so I say that. Oh, it's stupid, I know, but physical therapy appointment got moved up to today, so hopefully that can help. Yeah, for sure. For sure. Hopefully it does. Tagged you on Discord, Lutz. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Whatabouts? What I do this time? Castle, floors. What do I need for a forge floor? Sigil pattern or redoubt pattern? Blood essence bricks and, oh wow, lots of copper ingots. Okay. I'm going to have to, I think I might need more copper ingots than what I've got. 17. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I have 40. Okay. And how many to take? Was it four each or two each? Two each. Okay. So I can make 20 floors. Okay. And this is 1, 2, 3 by 3. Okay. What is this one in here? 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. That's 3 by 4. Oh, also 3 by 3. Okay. I think I am actually going to move it in here. I think I will. Okay. So I need blood essence. Let's see. Do we want the sigil pattern? I think we do. The redoubt pattern. I wish I could see this better. It's just giant brick. The sigil pattern looks kind of mystical. What I do this time should just be the go-to question for everything. Geez, you count me like 1740. Going to bed. Catch you tomorrow. Peace. All right, Moe. Thanks for stopping in, my friend. Glad to know you're doing well. Glad to know you're doing well and things are well. Blood essence and stone bricks. Stone bricks are in here. Blood essences are in here. All right. Let's refloor this in here. The sigil pattern looks pretty cool. Readout pattern also looks cool, but I think I like this one a little better. It just offsets the room. Whoa. I did not put one there. That's obnoxious. It like glitched on me. Yeah, look, I'm clicking. Look at where my mouse is over here, and it puts it all the way over there. How did that happen? That's annoying. Okay, well, whatever. So it's like a wooden or a metalish type floor, what it looks like. Okay, well, I guess I gotta put a regular floor back down. Is it diamond pattern? Yeah, that's a little obnoxious. Okay. All right. Okay, so let's move these guys in here. There we go. Okay. So now they should be able to make things much faster. So 15 iron ores. Wait a minute. Confined room. Did I not have that before? Wait a minute. Was it not in a confined room before? Hang on. Let's test this out. Because I could have sworn it took 20 iron ingots. No, it's still showing. Yeah, it does say 20. Oh, cost. Oh, right. Okay, I got my perks mixed up. Got my perks mixed up. Here we go. That's a huge help then. Make the cancel all fast. Fancy looks nice. I wish it was fancy yet. It's not quite there, but we'll get there. We'll get there eventually. Move this. Wait a minute. Which way is its mouth? Here it is. The devourer over there. Okay. So I need one more paper. And look at this. Boost all above effects by 30%. Gosh. Wish I could find 100% blood more often. Hey, how you doing? I still don't know if I said it right. If it was Mr. Selu TV. Played a lot of this game and only now I find out that you can move stuff. Wait, really? Hey, Andes. Welcome in. Is there a way to make the castle bigger? More rooms, big rooms? Yeah, there is. So Bookbunk, do you see this bloody thing right here? This castle heart. Mine is currently only level 2. But when I upgrade it next, I will get more of a castle capacity. So right now I only have 80 borders that I get, like 80, basically 80 squares I can put in here. But eventually, when I can upgrade it, I'll be able to make the castle larger. So right now I'm sort of outgrowing it. Well, I'm not actually outgrowing it. There's plenty of room for all my stuff, but to make it nice, it really needs to be bigger. So yeah, eventually I'll get there. But it's a little cramped. It's a little bit weird laid out. So yeah, eventually I'll make this a lot better. But what kind of server am I playing on? I'm playing on a solo local server. Hello. You got vampired. That's good. That's good. Mrs. Magoo's had some blood taken. So. It's like Marcelo. Oh, gotcha. Welcome in, Marcelo. Or Marcelu, I guess. Marcelu, is that what you're saying? With the U still? Maybe a dedicated Moose room? That would be nice. Yeah, the Moose kind of is just in the entryway for now. I might actually, you know, that might be a good idea. Maybe we'll make a Moose room. I'll put glue stick in here too. So it'll be like a stable. All right. So I think it would be best to go for some more paper again. So I think the nearest paper place is this one here. Let's run down there real quick. It is not public. It's not public. Yeah. Hi, Mrs. Magoots. How was her visit to see Edward? Edward? Oh, no. I hope not. Otherwise, what'd she even come home for, you know? I might get some papers over here. Might get some papers without even having to leave. Yeah, not quite. Merciless copper axe? Oh! That is very nice. Yeah, didn't even have to leave. We got a piece of paper right there. Megan the Moose greeting all the castle visitors. She's LARPing. Megan the Moose receptionist. Yeah, it's pretty funny. She's magical. She's really glitched is what it is, but we say she's magical. Let's research this. Eventually I'll get the whatever it is, the mace. That's the one I'm really wanting. But even still, merciless copper axes are solid. Yeah. Okay. Let's see, what do I need for those? Before I do that, let's build the study. Does this does not have a requirement. What else do I need to build the study? So under here, 40 planks, 8 grave dust. Okay, I have those. Megan and Elliot and glue stick. That is the bunch right there. It is indeed. I don't really like this open, like this entranceway area as a study, but at the same time, I don't really know. This room here is just so small. That's a problem. So, like, I should have more space for woodworking bench, but I'm right on the edge of a cliff. I don't know if you can see, but there's a cliff right over here. I wasn't really able to go any further back. So, which one is glue stick? Glue stick is the horse. Glue stick's over here. I am. Yep, here's glue stick. And then Elliot is my servant, who's currently out on a mission. I should get more servant coffins, though. I should do that. Because I think I can get enemies or servants that are stronger than Elliot. There's glue stick. Yeah, indeed. There's glue stick. Yeah, see? Man. a rather large table. Maybe I don't know. This is weird to put it in here, but I think I kind of have to. Running out of other space. So let's move. So we're going to have the forge, the furnaces in here with whatever. You know, what's so bad about putting a nice fiery crafting area right next to all of your papers? What's so bad about that? What's so bad about that? All right. So I made a study. You need 75 scrolls? Jeez, I thought this was actually going to be helpful, but it's not. I only have like 40. No, I have 24. But I can study that at least. Merciless Iron Reaper, for what it's worth. What's this? A two-handed weapon that deals slash damage and has greater effect on undead. Okay. Probably need a forge for that, which I don't have. Need a lot of iron, I think, for the forge. Where'd it go? No, it's under crafting. Duh. Alchemy table, tailoring bench. Oh, cotton yarns. Wonder if I can make that. And then a smithy, 32 iron ingots. Wowzers. Glue stick? Yeah, that was named by Spooky Deer. Servant mission thing reminds me of those crazy WoW quests that irritated me so much, really. They were nice enough to count offline time. Yeah, that would be great if this did. But really, like I said, it's more this game is becoming more and more apparent that it was set up for a persistent server with lots of people on it. It was. Whereas I feel like Valheim has a little bit of a better balance in that regard. All right, so unfortunately I had to use all the papers I had, so I can't discover a new technology. Yeah, I didn't know that. Yeah, Valheim has a nice balance between like some perks of playing solo and some perks of playing with a lot of people. So obviously you can gather resources much more quickly, food, things like that. Work out a lot better in Valheim with multiplayer, but for instance, like one thing that always kind of bothered me about multiplayer Valheim is your torches burn out. Your torches burn out, and they take a, I mean, I, like because the server is still running when you're gone, so they're timed. And so I always came back and my torches would be burned out in our persistent server. I'm like, man, it's dark in here, you know? So for the tailor, I need 28 cotton yarns. I'm going to be honest. I don't know where to get that. That's probably on these cotton farms up here. Are there any cotton yarns? Wool threads, plenty of wool threads. Cotton. I'm gonna be honest. I don't know where to get cotton yarns from, because I'm guessing you can turn. Well, hang on a second. Oh, probably from the loom. That's probably what it is. Interesting. So before I can make that. Yeah. Yeah, so here's the loom. I'd be able to turn them into like cotton yarns, right? Yeah, so that's a recipe for cotton yarn. Interesting. So I have to kill Beatrice the tailor to be able to use the stuff I got from who was it again? Where'd I get it? Woodworking bench. I don't remember where I got that from, actually. Where did I? Oh, it's from Quincy. It's from Quincy. I got the tailoring bench from Quincy. Beatrice the tailor is a funny one to fight, really? There's a mod for which part, Michelle? Oh, for the Valheim torches. Do bases decay over time if left unattended? They technically do. So this castle heart here, basically the base has a power source and it comes from this blood here. But as you can see, mine is going to be 5 days, 4 hours, and 32 minutes before my castle starts decaying. So it's going to take a while. It's going to take a while. My total playtime in this game is like 34 hours, something like that is my guess. So, I mean, yeah, it's going to take me a while to get to that point. Oop, hang on, possibly a work message. Okay, never mind. We're good. That does not need instant attention. Cool, you can monitor that easily. Yeah, very easily. Destroyed a couple castles on this PvE server. Did you really? Yeah. Work? Quit? How you doing, Wes? 34-hour stream incoming. Oh, gosh. After watching Spooky do a 12-hour, I don't know, and Slothy did a 24-hour, I don't think I could ever. The longest I've ever gone is like 7 hours. I don't know if I could do it. I don't know if I could do it. That is an awful long period of time to be on, you know? It does show the remaining time on this hunt, too. Waiting for the spot to open up, so I destroyed it ASAP, but now I don't want the spot, so I'm just take the mats. Wait, so how does the spot, like, what does the spot mean exactly? I've never done PvE. And my server, nobody's able to join to, like, come and destroy it. I don't know, that part of the game didn't really ever seem super interesting to me. I know it's a lot of people's, like, main reason for playing. But I've never really done it. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to store all these. Oh, I can. Okay. But not any longer. Not much longer. I got a lot of leathers here too. Okay. So, Merciless Iron Reaper. It's very cool. It has a greater effect on undead. That would be awesome. But I gotta make my forge. And the only way I'm gonna do that is by coming up here and getting more iron. Mosswick Village. Do any of these, I guess, Haunted Iron Mine. I was not able to get in the Haunted Iron Mine. I'm trying to remember. Militia holds the line against the dark forces that have awoken in the old mine. The miners fled the tall, dark figure commanding the undead horde, wielding a monstrous scythe. Let's see if we can figure out who that is based on images over here. It's not a scythe. Not a scythe either. That's another vampire hunter, though, right there, isn't it? Let's see. That's pretty scary. No scythes, though. I don't think that's a scythe. Those aren't scythes. I don't know. Oh, did you try posting a link, Andy, or was it, sometimes loot spot, if it sees a period without a space, it automatically reads it as a link. Apologies for that, my friend. Oof. Conquer versus collaborate. I'm team collaborate. Are ya? I usually am too. I usually am as well. All right. I'll go ahead and track Beatrice, but I have a feeling. Let's see, which direction are we heading? Yeah, that's kind of what I thought. It looks like probably north northeast. Yeah, northeast of here. So probably somewhere up over here, huh? I haven't explored much of the north yet. I need to do that. There's at least one waygate that I could teleport to. I have time. I think we'll just use the rest of the stream to do some exploration. Loot spot is out in full force. Double space my space bar on my phone. Oh, sorry about that. Yeah. Like you said, need yarn. I'm thinking, oh, I could specialize in yarn and give you all the yarn you need. I'll just be a yarn specialist. That's pretty funny. Yeah, sorry about that, Andy. So the reason Lootspot does that is just to prevent from like bots coming in. Sometimes bots come in and drop links. So it's just an easy way to make sure that they aren't able to do so. Apologies, my friend. But yeah, it does catch innocent people off guard, I guess, which is pretty annoying. All right. Almost nighttime. Yeah, we'll just go explore the north a little bit. Also, let's see what I need for my merciless copper axes. Rubies, whetstones, leather. Okay, let's do that real fast too. Dang it. Rubies, whetstones, and leather. Whetstones. Rubies. Leather. Fantastic. Might as well. I wish it increased my gear level, but it's the same, right? It sure is. All right, let's put these back and then we'll be able to go on our way here. Leather's back there. Not going to make canteens out of those just yet. Hey, I can definitely tell I'm faster because of this rogue blood. I like it a lot. I like it a lot. What, you don't want to buy followers loots? Yeah, I should. Maybe I should. Lootspot is a stone cold killer, I tell you what. That's true. Puts on a friendly face, but is just an absolute brutal murderer. Oh shoot, I forgot to clear this. I actually didn't even have to go down there. There we go. All right, let's do this. Teleporting over here, I guess. Merciless, like, has no feelings at all. It has just not a single feeling. We're gonna try to run as far north as possible. I have Beatrice tracked, for what it's worth. But I remember trying to run through a lot of these. They've got, like, fire arrows, and that was very scary. Very, very scary. A lot of these enemies are just too strong for me at this point. I think the game's gonna lag a little bit too. Is Beatrice in here? Beatrice, are you in that house? He is in the house. What? Uh-oh. Ooh, this is bad. Woo! See, this is why I've been avoiding this area. Militia camp. Okay, so we found Beatrice. For what it's worth. Who's this? Just a guard? At least there aren't, like, not everybody is a skull on my screen, so that's cool. If we can find, like, another waygate, that would be ideal. Whoa. Burke the Traveling Trader. He did not attack me the last time I found him. This is really stupid of me, probably, but... Maybe he doesn't go after wild animals? Maybe he only goes after... Vamps? Yep. Okay. I poked the bear. There's a waygate. We found one. Shrek? Wait, who is Shrek? Dunley Farmland's waygate. Okay. That is a very helpful waygate for sure. That one's also very cool looking. What's over here? A farm. Ooh, this is a really pretty farm. Hmm. Hmm. You got any containers? Yeah, there we go. See, that's what I need to do. Keep checking for containers. I don't want your worker blood. I've got 100% rogue blood. Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. Am I being run out of town by angry villagers? Kind of. Kind of I am. Honestly, some of them are terrifyingly powerful. Some of the villagers do actually fight back. Not all of them cower in fear. A lot of them do, but not all. Quick map check. Okay, we're working our way up towards the cursed forest. So that's probably a terrible idea. Nowhere near strong enough for that. I also need to be on the lookout for iron deposits. Because I need lots of iron ingots to advance in this game. And I've not really been on the lookout for them. One problem about the iron ingots, though, is the fact that I still can't teleport with them. Even though I tried turning that on, it did not work. Colosseum? What on earth? This is cool looking. Okay. A Colosseum. What kind of thing is this? Militia Brawler. We're going to turn around. There's another farm over here. We'll be able to find some scrolls, which is good. Wish iron deposits were easier to find. Oh, silver? Dang it, I'm not going to take the silver. I'm trying to explore and I can't do that very well if I'm not a wolf. Iron ingots seem to be universal, like you need them for nails and dinkum yesterday and on raft. Yeah, true. I need a lot of iron ingots right now, too. Is this cotton? Or those are just fibers, aren't they? I got a decent amount of cotton last time I was up here. But I can't really do anything with it just yet. Iron deposits. Iron deposits are, they kind of stand out because they're shiny. But yet, I still haven't located any. What is this? Torchbearer. Okay. There. Wait a minute. Oh, nope. That's copper. Okay. They're shiny, similar to copper, but silver. Silverish colored. What does fishing up here give me? Anything good? Oh, but I've done it. Need a cyber iron market? That'd be good. Or at least some way to help me track it better. Regular amethyst. Ooh, not a crude one. That's my first not crude gemstone. Scourge stone. Okay. Yep, you can tell I'm in an area that I am not yet progressed for. This, I have recipes. Well, I see that scourge stones are going to be important in the future, but I cannot make them myself yet. Okay. Hey, Koro, says Dr. D. Where is the iron up in this place? I need lots of it. Oh, crap. Hang on, I think it's... Yep. Yep, 10 a.m. now. What are those? It's a farm of some sort, but what are those? What if I just start swinging at him? Nothing. Okay, I don't know what those are. I guess nothing I can really care about. Like there might be a house up here on this hill. It's okay. All I want is your papers and your scrolls and such. It's all I'm here for. It just had the bookshelf. What's in here? Oh, there's something over here. Wait, was that? Oh, wool thread. Yeah. Wool thread, not the wool yarn. Whatever it was. Hey, wake the neighbor. Hello. Morning, Lutz. Long time no see. How are you doing? How are you? How's life been treating you? How are your late work hours going? Getting lots done? Yeah, actually. So I worked till about 11 last night. It was about 11. I got a lot done. I got a lot accomplished. I was telling Mrs. Magoots I had budgeted about 2 days for this task that I was doing, and I got it done last night. So I got it done all in one day, basically. And I had originally budgeted 2 days for it. So yeah, I'm optimistic. I'm feeling good about the timelines and the. It's a scarecrow. That scared me. Scarecrow be doing its job, I guess. It scared me. Where is all the iron at? My gosh. Can't find any of it. Where am I, though? Oh, it's probably because I might actually be too far north. I don't know. Time for me to get my workday started. Sorry you did about before stream ends, but I hope you have a wonderful day, Lutz, as well as the wonderful people in the guild. No worries at all. No worries at all. I hope you have a wonderful day. You have the wonderful list of days. Thanks so much for hanging out with us today, Peachy. Really awesome. Oh, shoot. Vincent the Frostbringer is actually kind of in. Oh, wow. That almost wrecked me. Oh, shoot. Knew that was going to happen. Should I go after Vincent? I don't know. I mean, it's almost daytime. I have good blood right now, so like I could at least try it. I could always run away. Ooh, that's bad. Dang. Okay, that attack is wrecking me right now. Yeah, I think I need to run away. I need to run away. I'm not ready for Vincent. Woof. Really awesome. Real busy, though. Thanks for asking. Of course. Of course. Glad things are going well. Let me turn into a bear. A bear will be better for me. Yeah, I just do not want to die right now. I just don't. I got good stuff in my inventory. I've got good blood I don't want to lose. Wish the blood lasted longer. Including the testing. Yeah. Hopefully, my hope was to have about 2 days before this product launches to be able to like go through everything and make sure things are good. So hopefully. Wait. There, wolves attack bears? Why? Why would they do that? Why would they do that? It seems very not smart. Seems very naturally selective of them. And here comes the sun. Just like that, things get intense. Yeah, I was doing good on my, doing really well on my, discovering, and then all of a sudden, oh look, Vincent the Frostbringer just randomly out on the road. I would like to kill him, but I don't think I'm strong enough at this point. I was not really prepared. If I had potions, I think it would have been a better situation, but I did not. Found no iron. That is just so disappointing. Where are we exactly? Still in Dunley Farmlands. Okay. There's this giant area that we've gone around that I can't seem to go into. What is this here? A militia encampment? Yeah. No testing, auto push to prod. That's, I mean, we like to do all of our testing in prod. Just kidding. No, we have some staging environments for sure. I just, it's a brand new platform. So like nothing's in prod right now anyway. It's all on stage because it's a brand new product. So has not yet seen the light of day. I'm getting quite frustrated by the lack of iron, though, for real. Like, what do I even come up here for? I wanted to discover, but I also... There's some quartz. There's some iron. Holy jeez. We'll try the axes this time. See, it probably doesn't give me any more or less than the sword did. That's why, yeah, 80 was about right. But that's why I got to get the... That's why I gotta get the merciless mace. Please bear with me. How you doing, Schooner? Welcome in. And Sassy, hello. We're playing some V Rising today. Playing some V Rising. Being a good little vampire. Mosswick Village, huh? Mosswick Village? Is that a unique village? Man, aside from one vampire being on this server, like what all is going on in this world where they have so many militiamen wandering around all the time? Oh, geez. Yeah, that's not good. Fire arrows, no bueno. Do not like to be caught on fire. My favorite meme. I don't always test. When I do, it's in production, of course. Of course. New militia in camp. We are, I mean, the good news is we're discovering a lot of the map. Oop, there we go. We got to miss that arrow. What's over here? Probably more fire arrows. Horse track? Oh, that's very cool. Look at all these horses. Ooh, black horses. Very pretty. Love to see the black horses. They're the prettiest. So I'm guessing it's just horses over here, right? Yes. Okay. Let's see. Which direction should I guess I could try to go a little more north again. Kind of tough. There's not much. Oh, garlic exposure. That's great. There's not much shade over. There's actually a decent amount over here. Still in the garlic exposure-y area. I'm kind of being a little risky here. Ooh, we got some glass. What's that? Villagers. Villager, that was a different character model than I had seen. Oh, there's some cotton yarn. Okay, that was one. How many? I need a lot of them though, don't I? Man, my garlic exposure is really high right now. See, that villager's coming to attack me. He wants to fight. He's here to fight. How else do we know if we can take down Prod or not? Exactly. How else are you supposed to know those kinds of things? Struggling with how to reproduce the production load on a non-production environment. All the large-scale resources. Without all the large-scale resources. This is another militia camp. There's nobody here. But there's also no containers. I'm going to be honest. I really did think that I would find a lot more iron today. Just since I was coming up north. Ducks. More garlic exposure. Gosh dang. So let's do a quick check. Monastery? I don't know which way to go. Good news is the moon's coming up soon. I need a tip on how best to find iron deposits, because I feel like this should be a lot easier than it is. I found a couple in these like meadowy areas, but I don't know if they're the best places to look. Basically, wherever I found quartz, I've kind of found at least one iron ingot. But it seems more like luck than actual skill. Give me the name where you find iron, but I play in Portuguese, so don't remember the name. Oh, really? Okay. You play in Portuguese. Are you from Brazil? Biggest area in Dunley Farms. Okay. Biggest area in Dunley Farms. Is it this haunted iron mine? This one here? Because I see iron ore there, but I have not been able to even get inside of that place. I'm assuming I'm too weak for it. It is that. Okay. I'll try to go in there on the way back. Excuse me. I'll try to find my way through. This is a cool meadow. As a boss inside, exactly. Yeah, that's what I figured based on the description of the place. Definitely sounded very scary. Another meeting coming up? Sounds good, Book Punk. I'm gonna have to drop off of here myself very soon. I had decent success finding iron deposits just wandering around last time. I found 4 or 5 of them, but today I found one. One. That is it. It's not been a very fruitful excursion. Can't quite go through there. Trying to avoid militiamen as much as possible. I wish you could continue running in the wolf form when you got hit, but unfortunately you can't. There's a cave passage. Cave passage actually saved me last time. I was about to be destroyed, and it definitely was a big help. If you stay in the entrance, there'd be no problem. Okay. It's good to know. The militia brawlers look like bosses because they're so large. And I have to run this way too. Gosh dang it. Any other way to go? I can try to creep around to the right, but I'm going to get spotted. Yeah. Here's Burke. Burke the Traveling Trader. There's some quartz over there. Okay, so maybe we might be near an iron deposit. If my theory holds true. There's one. I got worker blood last time, so I got a little extra iron ore each time. It actually made a pretty big difference. It was about 20 every time. And that was with like 23 or 33% blood. It was low quality blood, but it still was enough to make a difference. So if I ever really wanted to maximize that. So here's the quartz. Okay. Any iron deposits over here? Okay. Getting stuck. I don't see another one. Okay. Okay. It's over here, right? Woo! Yeah, there's one. Oh, yeah. I see what you're talking about now. How tough are these? Oh, shoot. I wandered right into that. That's not good. Yeah, I don't think I'm ready for that. I don't know if I'm ready for that or not. I've got a lot of garlic exposure right now. Okay, but we at least found there are plenty of deposits there. That's for sure. Son of a gun. Do not like the fire arrows. Okay. Yeah, maybe we'll get lucky and find like another deposit on the way out. But I've at least got some. I got what, 160, so I can make 10. Make about 10 of them. That's gonna be tricky. Tricky, tricky. Fire arrows are really annoying. Yeah, they are. Just the area of effect. And combine that with garlic and I die very quickly. I die extremely quickly. Okay, here's a quartz. Let's see, do we find an iron somewhere nearby? Oh, no, it's also possible I mined the iron. The last time I was here. I don't really know exactly where I went. Yeah, we did explore a good chunk of the map, which is cool. Good chunk of it. Yeah, I aggroed them pretty quickly because of my garlic stench. Oh, I needed, three more iron deposits, and I'd be able to make the forge that I need to make. And I'd be able to get some iron weapons, and that's going to be a huge boost to my progression. But until then, I'm kind of stuck. Do any of these have... These don't have iron in them, do they? Cotton Farm. Dawnbreak Village. Militia Camp. Yeah, I'm not seeing any iron ores in anything other than the Haunted Iron Mine. On a non-meme note, if you ever want to load test bees with machine guns, HURL and Siege are dope. Okay. Load test. That's not really my job, but I can definitely keep that in mind. Gotta get ready for a meeting. Sounds good. Quit? Wait a minute. What's this? Militia Crossbow. Jade the Vampire Hunter. I knew there was another Vampire Hunter. At least a couple. Okay. I can't go after Jade. She's way too strong. I could go this way, or I could just turn straight around and go back south. I think I'm going to do that. I've not found any other irons, and I'm going to go ahead and drop what I've got. Running a little low on blood. Got about a third left. Maybe even a little less than that. Disappointed overall in the amount of iron I found. But it is what it is. These kind of recon missions. Oh, there's one. Maybe I was looking too far north, like I said. Found four or five of them one time, the last time I was around, and I didn't go very far north at all. It's only 73. There's a sulfur over here, but no iron. Back to crude stuff pulling out of the pond. Okay. Yeah, I guess I am pretty much down back to my side of the map, if you will. The yellow side of the map. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to just accept what I did find. I think I'm just going to have to take it. would have been nice to find more, but I don't want to be too greedy and stay out for too long. My blood's going to hit zero soon enough. It was really, really nice having 100% rogue blood. Really, really nice. And the sun's coming up soon, too. I feel like I have an eye boogie, like, right on my face. I don't know if I do or not. That's what it feels like. If so, I apologize. It's gross. We found Beatrice the Tailor, though, which is interesting. Gosh, I just don't know. Other than getting, I think I have to get iron weapons in order for that to go well. That area up there is going to get brutal. I'll need to have garlic resistance potions, iron weapons, probably better armor, just all of it. Just all of it. All right, we got 233. So what's that divided by 15? My math skills are not the best. What is this? I'm going to be quite short. I needed about double what I found. Those are good there. I'm going to move this box over here. Couple glass pieces. There's the cotton yarn. That's pretty cool. My goodness, my friend. Celu TV, thanks so much for that. Subbing with Prime? My goodness. Seriously, cheers up to you, my friend. Means a lot that you'd consider me for the Prime sub. Much appreciated. I'm humbled. Very humbled and honored for that. Oop, not that. That one's full up now. Let's throw some of these in here. There we go. Cheers. I'll give you another cheers, my friend. Cheers to you. Cheers. Be cool. Watch you during work for sure. What kind of work do you do? Oh, man. Look at that. Look at that regular amethyst. Very cool. Found a regular amethyst and a regular emerald. My firsts of those. I don't know where I've been putting the cotton. I'll put the cotton in here. I don't remember where I put it. Web dev? Oh, cool. Same as me then. Same as me. Are you front end? I'm primarily front end myself. Oh, shoot. I forgot to put the yarn over there, too. All right. Scrolls. How many of these am I up to now? 50. Bad? Not bad. And the cotton. Okay. Is there a way to decrease the number of scrolls? I guess not. Love backend, but now you're full stack. Gotcha. Very cool. Very, very cool. Primarily front end. I don't do much else anymore than that. I We were kind of being cross-trained to be full stack, but that sort of fell by the wayside pretty quick. I don't know, just need leathers to repair those. That's easy. I don't know. It made more sense to have like DevOps and, you know, front end and back end and whatever. So I don't know. There were already people that did the stuff, I guess, but full cycle, back front and DevOps. That's very cool though. It's very cool. Friends, I have a meeting starting up here soon. I think it's probably best for me to call it a day here. So I'm going to do that right now. Let's head to the tavern. I got some thank yous to give out. And then I got to run to work. But thanks everybody for hanging out with me today. Had a blast. I actually made some decent progress, all things considered. Considering I couldn't find any dang iron. Dr. D, thanks so much for the 100 gold coins, my friend. And Coleman for being our mod for the day. Marcelo TV, One Rigor Mortis 1, and Shinsuke 888, thank you for the follows. Subs, True Celt and Marcelo TV, thank you so much, you both, for the support there. And Coleman, Iron Phil, Fresh, Creating Delicious, Peachy, and Spooky on the Ko-fis. And now I gotta add Book Punk to that as well. Gotta add Book Punk. So. Ursa, thanks for hanging out with us, my friends. Good chatting with you again. Yeah, tomorrow, it's a bit of a split day. We're going to play A Tale of Paper, likely be wrapping that up. And then once we do finish that up, we'll be jumping back into Raft to do some Raft maintenance. Going to be trying to continue up my renovations, just because I want to make a nice Raft in that, and just have some fun with that. So yeah, friends, I'll be back tomorrow. Same time, same place. Actually, before we go, though, I don't have to run right away to a meeting. It'd be nice if I could maybe drop into a raid. There is somebody I want to see if they're still online. Check in. They are still online, doing a massively long charity stream. Still another 2 hours left on the clock. They've been streaming for 237 hours straight now. We learned about this person from Dr. Wes Anderson. So, it's a charity stream going for extra life monies. So, yeah, friends, don't feel like pressured to contribute necessarily, but I do at least want to give a big thank you to this person for doing what they're doing. So we're going to go drop them a raid, hopefully put a little smile on their face, and just let them know that we appreciate them. So friends, I will see you tomorrow. Until then, take yourselves, be safe, stick around for the raid, and I'll see you soon. Love y'all. Bye.